about myself, it's a long story. It's a 50-year-old backstory that we go back into because I just turned 50 this year. And the story goes, like every normal girl, went to school, went to college, loved staying with my parents, got married, had a baby girl who I loved. My daughter's called Khushi. The name means happiness, and that's what she was to me. She brings me utmost happiness. And of course, it is challenging. As you know, as children grow older, the problems grow bigger. So life's been, it's been a life full of learning, a journey where there have been ups and there have been downs. And each one came with a feature which taught me a lot on how to handle life, how to go forward. And here we are today. So to say it in more a concise manner, I got married. Shifted to Singapore, been here very long, almost 2 decades now, and this is my home. My adopted country is my home. I still am very Indian, as you see. We're always dressed up in our most Indian attire, the sari. There were challenges, there were struggles, and one had to learn how to accept them and grow out of it with a solution. And that's exactly what I have done, Ruby. There was a big struggle. My marriage didn't last very well or very long, and I am a single mom now. And a life of a single mom or a single woman isn't very easy, especially if she hasn't ever worked in her life. I hadn't worked ever in my life, and I'm not at all apologetic about it because I had a good life. That life then and the life today, there's been a lot that has been learned. One of the biggest learning was that how to accept challenges, how to stand by, and how to empower yourself to keep going forward, to learn to create solutions and to ensure the solutions come in place so that we can make this a better life. I want to live every day, and I don't want to exist. I want to live life. So there goes on, the story just continues thereafter. Made me live. I think just the whole idea of living life to its fullest is one motto. But yes, Ruby, this wasn't easy. It wasn't easy because I had never worked. I kept living back. I stayed back in Singapore to live with my daughter here. It wasn't easy. You know how Singapore is. It's expensive.
Yes.
And you need to work here. Having said that, I learned, and very early in life, that you need to empower yourself. How does empowerment come in? Or how do you empower yourself? The only ways are that you find what is your purpose in life. You find what is it that you're passionate about. I did a lot of things. I went back to school. I went back to studying. I taught at a lot of schools. I would teach oral communication skills. And I loved my job. I loved being with children. I loved teaching them there. The only thing was it kept me away from my home for very long hours because this was all after school. Then came the whole idea of creating the buzz. The buzz happened. It happened more so because I had a lot of data on me. And then thereafter the buzz, we created the bazaar. The NRI bazaar came into existence, which totally completely changed my life because I met some phenomenal women. I learned so much from their skill set of, you know, continuing and to keep moving and to keep making the best of whatever they have here. And thereafter, the bazaar, we had very unprecedented times as such today. COVID, the epidemic came into place, and we've all been living with it, learning how to go forward. That is when Kitchen Connections actually came into life. Kitchen Connections is about bringing to the community here the best products from India at the best possible prices. The goal was a very simple one, that, you know, lifestyle doesn't come at a price. It comes at a good price, at the correct price, and that is exactly what we are catering to here. So the whole journey has been a learning in itself. You know, you had to do a lot of things before you found what were you passionate about, what was your purpose. To embrace a lot of challenges, you know, challenges, they need to be embraced. You cannot, any solution or any, you know, I firstly hate the word problem. I always like the word, you know, we have an issue and we need to find a solution to it. So challenges, issues, they all need to be accepted, embraced, and then you find your solutions thereafter. The solutions are always there. It's always around you. And it is only about picking the best solution, putting it in place and going forward. Another thing that I learned here was that you have to be yourself. You have to keep the grit, you have to keep the strength, and you need to keep going forward. And once again, you know, one thing leads to another. Strength comes when there is a passion. Passion comes when there is a purpose. Purpose comes when there is, you know, what you've created, you're not just passionately in love with it, but you believe in it. So your beliefs, everything, you know, it all leads to where you want to go. And you have to try a lot of things before you actually go out there. So it was a lot of things that I did. We faced a lot of problems, a lot of problems. There was all kinds of problems, you name it, but we learned on the job. And that is what helped me be who I am. And I am happy. I'm in a happy space. There are challenges even now, you know, we have shipments which flights get cancelled, shipments don't arrive, or it could be just manpower here in Singapore is very, you need good manpower, and for that you need to have good teams, but we have issues all the time. It's very rule oriented, but, and you don't break rules here. Nobody breaks rules here. You're not supposed to break rules here. So you keep it all, you go by the book, but you keep it all together with grit and with a purpose, and of course the passion, and the main thing, the faith that you can do it, and I want to do it. I have a lot of people to thank, Ruby, a lot of people, for the fact that they believed in me and they allowed me to be who I am, accepted me, and here I am. But having said that, I did go through a phase right after my separation that I did suffer a lot of isolation, more so because I was not ready to be anyone's purpose. It happens, but you need to keep telling yourself, you're not a project. You're not a project, you're not anyone's purpose. You are yourself and you can do it. So it's not easy, it happens every day. You feel it hurts when, you know, the people you've known suddenly isolate you or look down on you or want to give you a commentary which is not what you want to hear. Like in the instance we were just talking about some time back, there was someone who came and spoke to me, a good friend of mine, and she spoke to me about a whole lot of things about how I should stop living instead of what I should do to empower myself. It's not easy when you don't get the right advice. So the next big thing I learned here again was to find my tribe, to find those few people who would tell me the things the way they are. Tell me the truth, tell me what I can do, tell me where I am going wrong, tell me in my face, but keep me motivated and help me keep going forward. It needs a team to keep moving forward. You need good friends, you need a family who understands you. It doesn't always mean that people understand things, but you are together. A family stays together. Friends, good friends keep you together. There can be viewpoints which differ, but then again, that is a process of all putting it together and going forward. So I would say I have chosen carefully, walked this path very, very carefully, picking up what I truly need in my life, who I feel would help me go forward, because I wish to go forward. There is no point in, you know, keeping in hate, keeping in fear, keeping in pity, self-pity, or being a victim. It is all about living the moment. You live life to its fullest when you give it your best. And that is exactly what I'm doing right here with you. Living the moment, enjoying this. And as always, Ruby, like I always tell you, thank you again and again for, you know, when I talk to you so many times, I actually reflect back into where I started from and where I have reached. And it helps me. It helps me actually reinforce a lot of things I want to do going forward. And I take it back home with me, my journey ahead. Today, what we have spoken about before we started this, we spoke a lot. And there are a lot of things which I want to again reevaluate in my mind. How do I take it forward to making myself a better person, to doing more for my community, and doing a lot more for myself? When I keep happy, I am able to keep everyone happy. first and foremost thing that, you know, you need to believe in yourself. You need to tell yourself that this is a situation, you need to embrace it. Acceptance of a situation. Not agreeing to go and live by the rules laid out at that hour, but acceptance to what there is in your, what is being given to you, accept it. And I think the most important thing here again is education. To empower yourself with the right education of what your situation demands. You know, in the case of a separation, a lot of women don't know what to do. It's so important to know your rights. In case of an illness, we need to know what is the next step. Get the right doctors, get the right facilities to help ourselves go forward. For everything, you need to first accept it, put it together, and decide how to take it forward. But the foremost thing is you need to accept. And that needs to be done with a lot of peace, a lot of calmness, because these are very important. These are the things which actually attribute to a strength, a normal calm strength, you know, instead of having a mind wavering. When you're calm and peaceful, when you do it in silence, in, you know, with peace, you find the right solutions. It doesn't mean the first solution you hit has to be correct. It could be many, many things that you do that you find the right solution. In my case, one of the things was, it took me, I went through a lot of lawyers before I found someone who agreed to, or we reached a golden middle, because I wanted to do things in a certain manner, not be aggressive, not just let things happen, but the correct way forward. I found someone who understood what I wanted. I agreed to what she wanted, and or rather what is good for me, and we went forward with that. So anything, the grit, you need to keep that calmness and that grit together before you can actually take the step forward, how to ensure that the situation you are in has the right solution. It doesn't come overnight, it takes time. You need to rebuild a lot of things, it takes a lot of grit. So you need to keep telling yourself, I can do it. That's the biggest thing, I can do it.